Dugout Chatter is the most obscure, entertaining, and informative baseball channel yet. Brought to you by McKay Giffen and Jacob Williams. Welcome to the Dugout.
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the first postseason edition of Dugout Chatter. And our last video kind of ties into this one. We talked about the Nationals and the Dodgers having some big playoff droughts. The Nationals are yet to get past the division series. And with all those division titles the Dodgers have, no World Series to show for it. But Jacob, lead us into our fact of the day.
All right, so the fact of the day is today in 2012, Tampa Bay Rays pitcher David Price, they went and they were playing the Tigers, defeated the Tigers 6-2, and it was Price's 20th win. The first time in franchise history that any pitcher went and won 20 games. He was the first Southpaw, or even pitcher for that matter, to win 20 games in the American League since 2004 when Johan Santana did it for the Minnesota Twins. He also went and edged out Tigers ace that year, Justin Verlander, for his first ever Cy Young Award.
Oh, and I guess that leads us straight into the roast of the week, because guess what, David Price? You and the rest of your boys have October off. You won the World Series last year, but now you're not even in the postseason. Where's your star Mookie Betts? He ain't winning an MVP this year. Oh, I tell you what, you guys, have fun watching the Yankees play in October, because it's a good feeling, because we got schlacked by you guys this decade, but now it's our turn. The 10-year anniversary of MLB Network is the Yankees World Series win.
All right, and like we were talking about postseason, this is the best time of the year, and this is we're going to go and discuss the main topic of this video. We're going to discuss and predict the National League wildcard game being played between the Milwaukee Brewers and the Washington Nationals.
Tonight at 8 p.m., the Brewers last year, they put in game 163. They're familiar elimination games, as well as the Nationals for not being able to get past the division series.
Yep.
So what do you have to talk about as far as the matchup, Jacob?
So the matchup, I'm really favoring the Nationals. Obviously, we got our Nationals stuff that I'm repping.
Yep.
Wearing the Nationals shirt. Then we got Ryan Zimmerman bobblehead the Nationals. I'm predicting the Nationals to win this game, McKay. You look at Mad Dog, Max Scherzer starting for the Nationals. He hasn't been pitching well in August, has like little over four ERA since he's returned from his injury. But you look at him, he's still Max Scherzer. He's still going to take the ball, you know, give you everything he has, one game wild card. Plus, if he struggles, you still have Steven Strasburg and Patrick Corbin to go and pitch in the game to maybe close out a game. Steven Strasburg closed for San Diego State when he was in college. I think that the Nationals pitching is going to be too much for the Brewers. The Nationals at our home, I understand that the Nationals have lost two out of the three winner-take-all playoff games at Nationals Park, and Scherzer did pitch in two out of those three games. But I think the Nationals are going to be too much for the Brewers. Brewers aren't going to have Christian Yelich. Obviously, he's out for the year.
Mm-hmm.
I think that the Nationals are going to be too much pitching-wise. And then also offensively, you guys look at Anthony Rendon, probably one of the most underrated players in all of
baseball. Yeah, and
he's
looking at, and he's in the MVP discussion, you know. He's been phenomenal his whole career, and now he's getting his limelight.
I have the Nationals tonight. The Nationals are moving on. Okay, what's your prediction?
I agree with you there, put in the fact that it's a home game. Look at the Nationals. They're hungry. They have a lot to prove. They haven't been that deep in the postseason. I think this is their year. And Scherzer, with that broken nose injury he had, he still went out, pitched, and played his heart out every day. He's a bulldog competitor. And like you're saying, the pitching matchup is way in the Nationals' favor. And I think the Nationals' line is more stacked. You got Trey Turner, five-tool guy. Anthony Rendon, he's coming out having almost a 40-homer year. Juan Soto has been one of the best power hitters. And he's just completely filled the hole that Bryce Harper left for them. And one underrated piece that I think you should look at is Kurt Suzuki, because he is a very good catcher. And you look at him, he's not too shabby with the stick either. So with that stuff in mind, I give it to the edge to the Nationals. And yes, their bullpen is one of the weaker spots, but that's where the starting pitching comes into factor. And like you were saying, you can bring guys out of the bullpen that are your starters, because it's a winner-take-all game. And if you get it to Sean Doolittle, he can close it down too. He had some big games with the Athletics in his career. So I think it's easily in the Nationals' favor, and they're going to go to the division series against the Dodgers.
And one guy that we didn't discuss on the Nationals' side is Victor Robles.
Yeah.
You know, good center fielder, strong arm, very fast. Good, you know, when he gets on, he can get over, steals a lot of bases. And for the Brewers, you know, they had a really good season. They're playing the best that they've played. And they're playing the best baseball out of any Major League Baseball team in the month of August. I just think in this one-game wild card game, you have to win one game. The Nationals,
They really have a lot of depth.
And in a one-game like that, you can pitch anybody you want. And I just think they have the better arms to overcome the Brewers.
I think that's about going to do it for us today here at Dugout Chatter.
If you guys are newer to the channel, make sure you guys hit the red subscribe button below right here. Follow us on our social media platforms. Instagram is dugout.chatter, and then Facebook is dugout.chatter16. And the best way to support the channel is make sure you leave a like and leave a comment below. And as McKay and I always say,
see you in the dugout.